Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to start chapter 6, rocks and minerals. Students, do you know our earth is made up of rocks and rocks are made up of minerals? Each kind of rock is made up of one or two minerals or more minerals. So depending upon their formation, there are three kinds of rocks which are present in the earth's crust. So these three types of rocks are igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks and metamorphic rock. So first of all, we will discuss about igneous rocks. So there are so many types of igneous rocks, students, but today we will discuss only four. These are basalt, granite, obsidian and pumice. So these are the four igneous rocks which we will discuss today, because these are in our syllabus. Student, do you know there are two types of igneous rocks? First one is intrusive, the igneous rocks which are cooled under the surface, and extrusive, the rocks which are formed or which are cooled on the surface or above the surface. So first of all, we discuss about the formation of igneous rocks. How igneous rocks are formed? Student, do you know in the deep inside of earth or ground, there is molten rocks are present which is called magma. When it remains under the ground or under the earth, it is called magma, but sometimes this magma bursts and it comes out on the surface with great pressure. When it comes out on the surface, then it is called lava. Magma is called lava, and this process is called volcanic eruptions. In volcanic eruptions, the molten metals, molten rocks and comes out and in the form of a liquid, and also some gases escape to the atmosphere. Student, do you know igneous rocks are formed when magma cools and solidifies? Where sometimes it cools above the surface and sometimes it cools under the surface. So first of all, we discuss about this first type, basalt. Student, do you know this rock is a type of igneous rock? It is formed by cooling of lava on the earth. So it has fine grains and it is dense and dark in color. Now we come to our next type, granite. Student, it is the most common igneous rock and it is formed deep underground when cold liquid rocks cool and harden. So it is very hard and contains large size mineral particles. It has three types of minerals in it, which are mica, feldspar and quartz. And where it is used? It is used in making roads, statues and buildings. Student, have you seen this granite stone in your houses? In our houses, we use this granite stone also. And now third one is obsidian. Obsidian, student, do you see this is quite shiny. It is shiny. So obsidian is formed when lava cools quickly above the ground. It is shiny and glassy, and it usually found in black or dark color, and the edges of this obsidian are very hard, so this rock is used to make cutting tools. Now we come to our next type, pumice stone. Student, do you see the small holes are present in this rock? So these small rocks, holes are formed when the gases trapped inside releases during its formation. When it is formed, the gases, they escape during the formation, leaving the holes in the pumice stone, like the bread. Right? Bread has also small holes. During the bread formation, the gases escape out, due to which it has small holes. Student, pumice is the rock which is formed by quickly cooling of lava above the ground. And what is the use of this? It is used by the dentist for polishing our teeth. And also it is used as body scrubber. You can see this pumice stone in your bathroom because it is used as body scrubber. Now we come to our next type, sedimentary rocks. This is the second type of rock which we will discuss today. So what are these sedimentary rocks? How they are formed? Now let us discuss this. Student, are you seeing in this picture? first step is value. Student, do you know by continuous blowing of the wind, running water, you do heat of the sun and rain, the rocks, they break down into the smaller pieces. And due to continuous erosion by wind, water, ice or gravity, the rock particles, they move from one place to the another. And third step is deposition. In this process, the sediments, they lay down into the to the new location. Means they move from one place to the another place by means of wind and water, and they deposit to the other places. And number fourth is compaction. Compaction means layering and layering. Means layer by layer they deposit at place by means of wind and water. And in this way the sediments is formed out. And the sediment, the pressure is created by the layers above layer to the lower layers. Next one is cementation. Fifth step is cementation. Cementation means you can say sealing it. The particles of the sediments, they begin to stick to each other. Sediment particles, they stick to each other and they are cemented together by means of clay or other substances like silica or calcite. In this way, it becomes solidify and cement-like structure is formed. And now final product is ready, means sedimentary rock is ready. And this type of sedimentary rock is there, it is a type of sandstone. So in this way, the sedimentary rocks are formed. Here you can see in the upper layer the sediments are formed, and then by compaction layering and layering occurs, and then cementation occurs by means of silica and by means of other particles, and they become solidify and ultimately sedimentary rocks are formed. This process takes several years for the formation of the sedimentary rocks. Now we come to its types. First type is sandstone. Student, do you see the sandstone? Sandstone is the most common type of sedimentary rock. It has the small grains of quartz particle. It is quite shiny. Why it is shiny? Because it has quartz particle in it, and it is mainly yellow, brown or pink, red in color. And you can see the many buildings formed from this sandstone. Your red fort in Delhi, which you have seen, is also made up of red sandstone. So it is used for making buildings, etc. Next one is, you can say shale. Next one is shale. So student, this shale is a rock made up of clay or mud particles. It is used to make tiles and bricks because it contains clay. Next one is conglomerate. It is quite beautiful. Student, isn't it very beautiful? You can see so many colors are present here, and it is quite shiny and very attractive. So it is a rock made up of pebbles and gravel, which are held together by minerals and sand. Such rocks are either gray or orange in color, and it is used as an ornamental rock, and it is used for polishing ornaments. Next, type of rock is type of sedimentary rock is limestone. Limestone is made up of a mineral called calcite. Students, calcite mainly formed from the shells and the skeletons of the sea animals. The sea animals, when they die, they decompose, and their shells and skeleton form the calcite, and from this calcite limestone is formed. So what is the use of limestone? It is used for the formation of the chalk. Chalk is a form of limestone which is used for making bricks, glass and lime. And also it is used to write on the blackboards. Secondly, it is also used for separating pure metals from their core. For the extraction of metal, limestone is used. Next type is fossils. Students, do you know in ancient time, dinosaurs and other animals, they died due to some climatic conditions or due to other factors. But somehow they get buried in the ice or in between the rocks. So there are bones of animals, their shells and print of leaves, they preserve in the rocks. So these are called fossils, the dead remains of the ancient animals and plants, which we can say imprint we can get. They are called fossils. So these fossils helps the scientists in understanding what kind of life exists in the ancient time. So these is also a type of sedimentary rocks. Now we comes to our third type, metamorphic rock. Students, do you know these metamorphic rocks are formed by the heat, pressure, or chemically reactive fluids? Also, they are produced from igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks, and other metamorphic rocks. Metamorphic means the outcome of the rocks that have been changed by heat and pressure. So, the igneous rocks, so they are sedimentary rocks. They can metamorphosis process takes place, and ultimately they changes into metamorphic rocks. So we discuss about its type. First type is marble. Student, this is the first type of metamorphic rock, and it marble is formed from the sedimentary rock, which is called limestone. So it is formed from limestone. It may be white or gray in color. It is used for making statues and buildings. Taj Mahal is made up of white marble. Right? Next one is gneiss. It is a metamorphic rock formed from the igneous rock granite, and it is used in making statues and buildings. Next one is slate. Slate is formed from the sedimentary rock shale, and it is used for making roofs of the houses in the hilly areas. The roofs of the houses are made up of slates, and also we can use the slates and blackboards for writing purpose. And this rock is, you know, gray or black in color, and it is quite shiny. Next type of rock is quartzite. Quartzite rock, it is formed by metamorphosis of sandstone, a sedimentary rock. It is very hard, so cannot be used for making buildings, but can be used for making statues. So with this, we discussed the different types of igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks, and metamorphic rocks. So our topic is over. So with this, have a good day, students. If you have any query, you can ask me personally. Have a good day, students. Thank you for watching the video.